Do you give credence to the fact that Jordan agreed to do this on the day LeBron won in Cleveland? Do you give any credence that Jordan, it was kind of firing a shot across the current generation's bow?
None.
Okay.
None. I'm going to mention it. Okay, this is an off-the-record thing, which he would probably frown at me for telling it, but I'm going to tell it. So there are times earlier in LeBron's career, and sort of sprinkled throughout, where people got critical of LeBron, whether it was the decision or whether it was a play, passing off to Donyell Marshall, whatever. If people think Michael Jordan resents LeBron, to me, there's evidence to the contrary in that there'd be a phone call. And I'd answer the phone, and this is what I'd hear on the other end. Hey, don't take a shot at LeBron. That's just garbage. This kid is great. There's no need to take a shot at him. That conversation is playing out with him knowing it's not going to be repeated. It's not going to be told on PTI. It's not going to be written about in the Washington Post or on ESPN.com. And so that happened. And that happened with young players that Michael liked, occasionally, somewhere between occasionally and frequently. You know, Russell Westbrook, Steph Curry, early on, people think, oh, Curry's not going to. You know, there were certain players that Michael would call and say, hey, stop. This is nonsense. Or if he knew I knew the person, hey, man, tell your boy he's wrong. LeBron James is going to be one of the great players of all time. So the notion that Michael resents LeBron or he planned it out, first of all, it goes against everything else we're saying. I mean, I know people think it plugs into the competitiveness angle. I don't think that plugs in at all. Because when Michael talks about taking on other players, it was on the court. It's Clyde Drexler, the Bad Boy Pistons. It's on the court. And he remember, LeBron has proclaimed himself the greatest ever. He did that on his own platform. Michael, in an interview with me that appeared 17 minutes live on SportsCenter, Rich, the morning of his Hall of Fame induction, Michael said, you can look it up, it's on YouTube. He says, I'm never going to consider myself that. I'm not going to say I'm better than Bill Russell or Kareem or Magic or Larry, I think, were the four players he named. I think he named Julius as well. And he said, because I said to him, it's important for you to be known as the greatest player ever. And he said, no, I'm not even going to say that. And people can look that clip up. I have it actually on my Instagram page. And so I've heard this theory, but it goes against what I know he thinks about LeBron. Just like people thought he thought something about Kobe, and now they find out. People thought he thought a certain thing about Doug Collins, like he wanted to get rid of Doug Collins. They find out how stupid that narrative is. It was just wrong. He loved Doug Collins. He didn't even want Phil Jackson, which he said. He wanted to play for Doug. So continue to play for Doug. So my take on it, and it's just mine, is that I don't believe that. And I have not asked Michael about it. Let me be fair. I have not asked him about the timing of the yes and LeBron. But what I know that he thinks about LeBron and how great he thinks LeBron is, I don't see it that way.